Howdy, so this is my T60. It was kind of built from a bunch of parts, laptops. I purchased 4 T60s for about $40 at Goodwill Computer Center. 2 were used to make a T601 Frankenpad, which is still a work in progress. I think the backlight's dead. I set up a working T60P at my parents' house. I think it's had a 1600 by 1050 display. It wasn't 4.3, unfortunately. And I made a regular 14-inch T60 for Libreboot. So to switch things up, I installed Arch Linux instead of Debian this time around. The T60 comes in a few variants, but this one has Intel graphics and, you know, the 4.3 and 1400 by 1050 display, but pretty much it's like a bigger socket. It's like a bigger socketed version of the X60, which is like this one over here. So I mean, look at the size difference. So, anyways, I upgraded it to a Core Duo Core 2 Duo, because unlike the X60, the T60 is socketed. So, both computers are easily Librebootable, although some LCDs on the T60 won't work with Libreboot. There's a list on their website. And, there's also, if you have a T60 with ATI graphics, you're kind of out of luck if you want to Libreboot. You can compile a core boot version with extracted binary blobs. So, I guess the nicest thing over the X60 seems to be the option for higher resolution displays. The X60 comes with a 1024 by 768 panel, and although it's very small, like almost netbook sized, 1024 by 768 still it's a little bit lacking. And you can put like a 1600 by 1200 panel in the T60, and I think one of the widescreen variants you could put like a 1900 by 1200 panel, which is kind of a lot. There's actually a mod for the X60, but you have to use to put like a 1400 by 1050 IPS panel in it, but it's kind of expensive and requires a extender cable, I think. I'd have to look it up though. So anyways though, sorry for that tangent. T60 was built from leftovers of the Frankenpad. I did not get a $10 T60. I got a $10 T60 with some dead pixels. So I stuck in a I got the T61 screen from the Frankenpad and put it on top, and it seems to be working fine. So here's the original display that came on it. Anyways, rather than that, it has a soft spot where the hard drive is. It's electrical taped and cardboarded in. But, at the moment, this is the, setup for it, I guess. Okay, so, what are my first impressions of Arc? So far it seems alright. It's, fairly easy to install. Although you have to do manual partitioning and there isn't a graphical installer. Arc is a rolling release, so it's more likely to break, but the packages are a lot more up to date than something like Debian Stable. Since Debian SID broke USB support on the T60P right out of the gateway, I think Arc Linux is more stable than Debian SID. Overall though, I think I still prefer using Debian. It's a little bit easier to install. I prefer apt-get to pacman. And Arch Linux doesn't have x86 32-bit support, so I can't even install it on this, or I can't install the latest one on here, which would kind of defeat the point of installing a, you know, rolling release to get the latest packages. So at the moment, I think I'll stick with Debian's dinosaur era packages, but rock solid stability. So I installed i3gaps, which was nice because i3gaps is actually in the package manager, unlike in Debian. So, but I don't know if maybe I was using Pac-Man wrong or something, or maybe it's just separated out, but I had to install dmenu and i3status separately, whereas in Debian you kind of just install, well, you don't install i3gaps, there's actually some GitHub link that generates a deb file you can install i3gaps from, but it handles the like status and dmenu stuff with the i3 package. So, the main thing though, the most important thing, is now I have a cool fat guy triangle. So when I do a screen fetch, I can just show the fat guy triangle. Oh, and I guess some final things. If you're wondering how the T60 aged, I'd say it's perfectly usable in 2018, at least for most tasks. It has this T60 has a mechanical hard drive. So applications will load a bit slower than if you have a SSD. Anyways, have a good weekend, and sorry for the video hiatus. I have uni now, and I went to Korea for a little bit.